After a ride of a mile, we reach the Anakin, a small mountain brook of 2 feet in width, running over a stony bed, well skirted with bushes but without grass. We turned up this creek, nearly due west, following its narrow gorge averaging in width from 100 to 200 yards, walled in on either side by high hills of nearly perpendicular sandstones. Our Indian guide told us that a circle in red, high up on a sheltered rock on the face of one of the hills, where some rude human figures were seen, were a great wonder to him, and he had attempted to describe them to us during the previous day, telling us that they had been made by an American captain on his way to California. This gorge is cut into deep gullies by streams which pour down the mountains during storms, which gave us some labor to cross, and a small stream coming in from the south also detained us a short time. But after following it for 2.5 miles, the Spanish Trail branches. The southern branch following the stream passes over a higher elevation and soon rejoins the northern branch, which, though longer, crosses the mountain at a lower depression.
Manuel says el jefe, just follow the blazes and cairns up the ridge to the top. There's a series of high mountain valleys and several small lakes that will tempt you to stop. But keep climbing till pinyon and sage change to aspen and spruce and sweet meadows of grass. Climb some more and you'll find the reward for your work, as the gem of this cutoff is laid out before you at last. Outlaws and Indians, pioneers and priests, slaves and drovers and mountain men, all tell the tale of the longest, hardest, crookedest pack your trail ever devised, the one they call the Old Spanish Trail. If I were El Dueño, I'd build my hacienda right here on the shore where I stand, and every rich don and doña would come here to gaze on the richest fish lake in the land. And graze their spent animals on my fine grass, and wish it was them that lived here. But they'll never arrive, 'cause the only way in would make kindling and splinters of their fancy carriage, I fear. Outlaws and Indians, pioneers and priests, slaves and drovers and mountain men, all tell the tale of the longest, hardest, crookedest pack your trail ever devised, the one they call the Old Spanish Trail. What a shame that Rivera, Dominguez, Armijo, Garcés, and De Anza all missed what to me is the jewel in the crown of this arduous trail. If by some miracle I could call them together to dine by my lake, I'd insist that my huge Mackinac be the feast to reward their travail. On this trail where outlaws and Indians, pioneers and priests, slaves and drovers and mountain men, all tell the tale of the longest, trail ever devised, the one they call the Old Spanish Trail. Slaves and drovers and mountain men all tell the tale of the longest, hardest, crookedest pack mule trail ever devised, the one they call the Old Spanish Trail.
Stand and face another foe.